and we're very proud that we did.
Dave's Battle of Britain training is now drawing to its climax. Peter Kinsey has been teaching him the classic repertoire of aerobatic skills, rolls, loops and half Cubans, to add to what he already knows about navigation and formation flying. In 1940, Dave's next home would have been an operational squadron, where, like those who went before him, he would have had to apply all he had learned to stay alive in one of the most ferocious air battles in history. There remains only one last thing for our trainee Spitfire ace to do, a graduation display, demonstrating his newfound skills. On the ground to watch him are his instructors, Brendan O'Brien and Carolyn Grace, as well as Battle of Britain pilot, Pete Brothers.
Wonderful sound.
Wonderful. Should we do a loop?
Loop, okay. Loop it is.
Okay. Yeah. So straight ahead?
Yeah, straight ahead will do just fine.
250 or 270?
270 again, yeah.
Okay, we've got enough power there.
Yeah, 200. Okay.
Did you do victory rolls when you came back to your home base? It was frowned
initially,
upon. Initially.
And then we stamped on it.
Why? Too many people were whistling in.
Yeah. And you could have had battle damage, which
yes.
You didn't know about.
Yes.
Dave's come a long way since he first climbed into a Tiger Moth. He has joined an exclusive club, pilots who have not only flown the Spitfire, but flown it close to its limits. He's been given a unique insight into at least one aspect of what training for the Battle of Britain would have been like.
Well, Pete, that was amazing, that. Thank you very much.
My pleasure. It's good fun, isn't it?
Yeah.
Nothing quite like it. Nothing quite like it.
Now it is time to meet someone who did it for real. Hurricane and Spitfire pilot Pete Brothers, who shot down 8 enemy aircraft during the summer of 1940.
You enjoyed it?
Yeah, like nothing else. It was unbelievable. Yeah. Yeah.
And now the crucial question. After 9 hours at the controls of a Spitfire, how would he cope with combat?
How do you think I would survive?
Yeah. If it was back there 50, 60 years ago.
I honestly think I'd fly the aircraft. That wouldn't be a problem.
You'd give it a good go.
I'd give it my best shot. I think I'd do.
I think you would too.
Okay, it just as long as he's 109, as long as nobody spotted me.
That's the one. Yeah, it's the one you don't.
Like all Battle of Britain pilots, Pete Brothers had a number of tricks of his own, designed to make himself harder to shoot down.
As I always flew with a bit of rudder trim on, so if I was jumped, I wasn't going when the chap fired ahead. Deflection. I wasn't going there.
You wasn't.
I was pointing there, but I was actually going there.
Okay, so sort of slipping or skidding across the sky.
Yes. Just a little bit of trim. That's all.
Really.
Didn't affect your performance.
Extraordinary.
The only thing you took it off before you fired. Otherwise, you were pointing
yes,
the wrong
in the wrong direction. Yes.
But it meant that when you would jump, you didn't get hit. You'd see the stuff going past.
Excellent. Now that must be the best way to see it.
Dave's training is now over. He's had the same 9 hours training as many young Battle of Britain pilots received before having to fly into combat. But Carolyn Spitfire has one last piece of history to make. For the first time in over half a century, Pete Brothers will once again take the controls of a World War II Spitfire. Just over 3,000 pilots are officially credited with having taken part in the Battle of Britain. Some, like Pete Brothers, survived and flew throughout the war. For others, combat lasted only days, or even hours.
You're flying my aeroplane. I'm greatly honored, sir.
It feels just like they used to feel.
If there was one maneuver the Spitfire was born to fly, it is the victory roll.
So you have control?
I have control.
You have.
The Battle of Britain claimed nearly 3,000 Allied and German lives. Today, there are only a couple of hundred or so Battle of Britain pilots left alive. For all of them, Britain's finest hour was theirs too.
The Battle of Britain is really a story of sacrifice. Those who benefited were the countries of Western Europe. It was a unique case of one country espousing a greater cause, represented by this handful of young men, the few, as they're now known, who went up to defend their own skies, but were actually defending something much greater at the time. It was, by any measure, not the meanest of acts among nations. This, I think, if anything of ours, is worth your memory.
I heard the Merlin start up, and I thought, I'm going to have a look at this, and they plummeted off, you know, it was just like a scramble, really. I was back 60 years, 70 years, yeah. Full of ghosts, those aeroplanes were, my old mates.
He said, you've had a rough time, haven't you? I said, no, I haven't had a rough time, a wonderful time. He said, your nerves are completely shot away.
They were the happiest days of my life. I'd do them all over again if I could, and do the same thing.
And then I had nightmares which have persisted the rest of my life. It's something you grew to live with. It's a kind of scar of honor, if you like.
We were faced with something, and we did our best, and we won.